Are you looking to learn the basics of naming organic compounds using IUPAC name? If yes, you've clicked on the right video. Hi, I'm Dr. K and welcome to ChemSimplified. This is part one of a two-part series in naming organic compounds. Before we get started, let's go through a few terms you may encounter in this video. First being unbranched versus branched. Unbranched compound is shown on the left-hand side, where you have, in this example, four carbons connected straight in a row, whereas branch is the one that is shown on the right-hand side. Notice, in addition to the four carbons that you have straight in a row, there is an extra stuff that's connected on the second carbon, and that stuff is called substituent. So having substituent in the chain is going to make it a branch compound. In this series of video, I'm going to focus on naming mostly unbranched compounds. When it comes to naming organic compound, there are several systems that exist, but the most popular or the most widely used is by IUPAC, which is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, and that is the system that we will follow in this series of videos. So I will post more videos on naming substituted or branched organic compounds in the near future. So do subscribe if you haven't done so. That way you won't miss out on new videos. Here are the 13 functional groups. In this part, we are going to focus on the first column. And the second part of this series is going to focus on the second and the third column. So since this video is going to be slightly long, I'll place the time marker in the description box below for each of the functional group we will cover in this video. So first thing first, before we get started, we need to first know how to address the number of carbons in the compounds. So we're going to use prefixes. So if you've gone through naming covalent or molecular compound, you should already be familiar with these prefixes. Most likely, you only need to know up to 10. However, just in case, if you need to know up to 20, I've included them here as well. So this is the first step of our foundation. And you want to make sure that you have a copy of this chart. It's going to come in really handy. So are you ready to start naming our first compound? This is an example of alkane. And let's start with the first step. So the first thing we're supposed to do is to find the longest chain. So if we look at this compound, we can see that there are five carbons connected straight in a row. So you start numbering the carbon from either the left-hand side or the right-hand side. If there's a branch, we start numbering nearest to the branch. If there are no branch, so in this case, I'm just going to number it from left to right. Okay, so we have five carbons. And now, if we have any substituent, we're going to number and name them. But in this example, since we're warming up, there is no substituent. So we skip step three and we move on to step four. And step four is to name the parent chain. And the way we're going to name the parent chain is we're going to start off with a prefix and then add in A and E. So I'm going to demonstrate. Let me pull up that table of prefixes. All right, so looking at our parent chain, we have five. So five, the prefix is pent, P-E-N-T. And then we're going to add in A and E, and that is to represent alkane. So all in all, the name for this compound is pentane. So P-E-N-T for the five carbon, A and E to represent alkane. Pretty simple, right? Okay, so let's go one step further and put in a substituent. So right now, we're going to go through the same steps. First is find the longest chain. So as you can see, there are four carbons and then one extra stuff connected to it. Now we're going to start numbering because now we have substituent. We have to make a decision and we are going to start numbering from the left. It would be 1, 2, 3, 4. So the substituent is actually at the second carbon. And now to name this, we're going to first put in a number to indicate where the substituent is located. And then we're going to put in the name of the substituent. Okay, and the way we do that is we put in the prefix and then we put in YL. So this is how we're going to do it. So it's at carbon 2, so we're going to put a 2 and then hyphen. Anytime you have number and alphabet, you need to separate them using hyphen, which is the dash. So we have two dash and then prefix. So look at our substituent. We have a CH3, so that's one carbon. So that means our prefix is METH. And because this is an alkyl group, because it's not alkane, it's missing one hydrogen. So this is an alkyl group. So we're going to end it with YL. So far what we have done is we have number and name our substituent. And then moving on, the last step, we need to name the parent chain. So the parent chain, we have already counted, there are four. So the prefix for four is but, B-U-T. And then we end it with A-N-E because this is an alkane. So as a whole, the name for this compound is 2-methylbutane. So if you are able to name alkane, you can name a lot of organic compounds. And you're going to see what I mean in this video and especially in part 2 of this video. Okay, so now that we've named alkane, let's just bring it a step forward and let's try to name an alkyl halide. So here is an example of alkyl halide. So the same thing that we have to do is always just find the longest chain. So in this case, we have 6 carbon connected straight in a row. So we're going to start numbering nearest to the branch. So in this case, the branch is Cl. So we're going to start numbering from the end nearest to branch, which is from the right hand side. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 carbon. And then now we're going to number and name the substituent. So the substituent in this case is our chlorine. We don't call it chlorine because when it is a substituent, you shorten the name. If it's fluorine, you would name it fluoro. Chlorine, chloro, bromine, bromo, iodine, iodo. You get the point. So in our case, we have chlorine, so we will call it chloro. So in front of the chloro, we're going to number it. So chloro is attached to carbon 2, so it's going to be 2-chloro. And then after that, we're going to proceed and name the parent chain. So we have already counted, there are 6. So the prefix for 6 is hex, and the suffix, which is the N part, to indicate that it's an alkane, is going to be A-N-E. So all in all, the name for this compound is 2-chlorohexane. Now let's move on to alkene. Alkene has a CC double bond. So in this example, we see that we have a CC double bond between carbon 2 and carbon 3. So when we name alkene, we have to first find the longest chain. When we find the longest chain, we have to make sure that both the carbon, which has the CC double bond, is part of that parent chain. And this is very important. So now we need to number from the end that is nearest to the CC double bond. So in our example, left-hand side is closest to the CC double bond. So we're going to number it 1 through 6. And then we name the parent. And the way we're going to name the parent is we're going to start off with prefix. And then we put in a number where the CC double bond is. And then we put in E and E to indicate alkene. So let's look at this one. We have 6, so that is hex. And then that number that you're going to put is 2. Because the double bond is between carbon 2 and carbon 3. So you're going to use the smaller number. So that will be 2. And then E and E. See, that's pretty easy, right? I told you, if you can do alkane, you can do pretty much a lot of the organic compound. Now let's bring this one more step higher, which is alkyne. That has CC triple bond. So same thing, find the longest chain. In this case, we have 5 carbon and make sure that longest chain cover your CC triple bond. That's similar rule to alkene. So now when you number, left hand side is still the nearest. So we're going to number 1 through 5. And then we're going to name the parent chain. So same thing as well. Prefix plus the number plus Y and E. So in our example, there are 5. So 5 is pent, P-E-N-T. And then the number, the same deal. The triple bond is between carbon 2 and carbon 3. So always go with the smaller number. So it's hyphen 2 hyphen. And then Y and E. So like I've mentioned before, whenever you have alphabet and number, please make sure you insert the hyphen. That is very important. So we're done. We have already named alkane, alkene, alkyne, and alkyl halide. So now we're left with the last one, which is arene. So we're going to keep this simple. We're going to just go with naming one substituent on the arene. In this example that we have, what you have to do is identify what your substituent is. So in this case, we have a substituent containing 2 carbon. So that's ETH because that's 2, ETH. And then you need to add in the YL to indicate it's an alkyl group substituent. And then after that, you put in the parent name, which is benzene, ethyl benzene. Done. So that's it for this video. We have covered alkane, alkene, alkyne, alkyl halide, and arene. I've gone ahead and put up the rest of the functional groups, and you can see how I go through each of these naming in the second part. So I'll see you in the next video. As usual, do subscribe and click on the bell icon and head over to ChemSimplified.com. You will find a blog post related to this video and some practice questions to test your skills. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in part 2 of this video.